Welcome. I'm so glad that you can join me here today, 299, excerpt 724, and pages 725 out of 850. This is an audiovisual version of my book, named after my ministry, The Sovereign Light. And my name is Reverend Maria Arvanitidis. And this is a course in metaphysical spirituality. And like always, with every episode, we start with a paragraph to open up into today's activation affirmation. And sometimes I even wonder what I was thinking when I was doing these statements. However, it's all good. And it opens up into a sermon somewhat, if it can trigger us throughout the day and support us in this activation. So let's find a comfortable place that we can always, this is a practice to learn to take with us in every moment of our life, meaning mindfulness, being present in the here and now moment, where nothing of the past or future will take us out of it, because it's all here in this moment. Nothing else really exists. It's all in here, omnipresent. As we combine and dissolve all the membranes of the many different layers of the, if you will, the unconscious, subconscious, conscious, and superconscious. And with that said, let's focus on our breathing. And whether we section it or we simultaneously at the same time learn to visualize in a multi-dimensional way, the less we resist, the more we can find it easier to practice, where it becomes like nature, a natural thing. We just are in this way of noticing the many beautiful, magical things around us that one might even think, be it miracles. In this way, let's focus on our breathing with our back straight. Always keep your back straight, whether you be sitting, standing. And where are we standing on? And connect, energetically connect, feel the connection to the earth, and become one with the earth. And feel the connection to the ethereal, the sky, and at the same time, open up to it by breathing in from the soles of your feet, your tailbone, and the crown, the top of your head. Just breathe in into this heart space center, anchor here, congregate here, and then feel it breathing out into this resonating field. And spontaneous in this moment, as each and every episode, anything goes. And to really appreciate the background creation of a female artist, so very beautiful. So let's center, let's find the center point. And out. And breathe in. And out. Let's begin. As was mentioned in previous, the mind was not meant to hold for conflicting beliefs, and thus must find a way to clear and work through this place of in between life and death. It can become somewhat confusing to some that have had the pleasure of owning such a state and in that way of being gatekeepers. Have you heard of it before? One foot in the grave and one foot in the living. So, this here, activation, might be a lengthy statement. Sometimes I wonder even if it's like a prayer, like combined with a couple of activations. And so you can find it separately attached or alongside with this episode on its own, maybe even on TikTok. However, let's begin to say these words out loud. Sounds good? See what we can get from them. I can continue to be by me by rediscovering from a higher awareness that before had subconsciously undertaken to authentically perform only within dreamtime space. I can continue to be me by rediscovering from a higher awareness that before had subconsciously undertaken to authentically perform only within dreamtime space. I can continue to be me by rediscovering from a higher awareness that before had subconsciously undertaken to authentically perform only within dreamtime space. And by learning with this in-breath and out-breath how the two worlds can combine, and from this eight to untwist into one reality, into this multi-dimensional law of creation. To have one foot in the old world and one in the new comes of no surprise to bring about conflicting beliefs. To reinvent the self in every given moment is to accept all of the part that makes up self wishing to express at any given moment. The key to its congruency is synchronicity that may arise, the choice to respond with simultaneously as one and from a different aspect of itself. From the state of being, to go accordingly along this lead to follow, how does the self feel? This is the only thing that self is held responsible for, and as a guide, it can, through soul, be that. How it's done is by the heart remaining open. Pages 725. I can continue to be me by rediscovering from a higher awareness that before had subconsciously undertaken to authentically perform only within dreamtime space. Does the self choose to live in the old world or the new world? This does not depend on talent keeping waves of energy for substance, and that it may thrive on, because it can just as long as those emotions do not crush it to the earthly levels of the old upon which its very own survival to exist was created. to chase and climb upon those waves rather than transition to find upon them and be guided by the surf. Transitioning to recycle from this earthly body is becoming that of choice. Death and aging was made before unconsciously through other timelines that the higher self and oversoul could only know to have agreed upon when it happens. The connection can be made to this feeling of knowing, and when the tired state of its time, it must depart, but only from its body to recycle. There are no accidents that can be when the self has awakened from its sleep. As wise and responsible over its world and connect with its soul in this way. Maybe this is the learning that time might near to give thanks and let go of the world it once knew, not deserving to be in, because the mirrors always played its part, the best for it, leaving it out altogether from the enslavement. The purpose here for today and onwards is for the self to effortlessly exist amongst the many who do accept and have its interest best at heart. Then it too will be able to contribute and well from this place called authenticity. So, the less popular of the two, this thing called authenticity, to be real, to be truthful to oneself, and to be accepting and loving of your energetic signature imprint of who you are, and nurture that. Or the other, from the old world, ego-driven reality of faking it till you make it.
Yeah, I like that.
That is the most popular and yet so hard to fit in, and effort and struggle and lack and arguing for our limitations of something we really are not, rather than just accept who we are and love that. That, in truth, is the greatest achievement. To feel that. And that happiness is, in truth, being rich, being successful. And I will leave you with today's activation. I can continue to be me by rediscovering from a higher awareness that before had subconsciously undertaken authentically to authentically perform only within dreamtime space. So continue to be you by rediscovering from a higher awareness that before had subconsciously undertaken to authentically perform only within dreamtime space. And I will see you there on the next episode. Much love.